Darth Dawkins.
Yo, what's up? What's up? We're here. We're here. The troll, this guy. This is gonna be hot. Oh,
this man who has his ball sack sags down to his knees.
We're gonna make him come.
It's about to be one preacher on another, one conservative on another. Yeah.
And Iron is forgot to take his medication, and now he's random. If he joins after, please send me that because I'm uploading some of that. No, don't call him.
I'm gonna ask him to send nudes.
Do not. If you do that, I'm going to be pissed.
Wait, how old is he?
He's 60. Like around there. Freak.
Isaac, read my fan fiction.
Wait, imagine if Isaac meets Darth Dawkins.
Yes, we got him.
Yeah, he is.
This is an infamous person I've been hearing
about. I was, for the record, I was the one that brought him in this community, and
hearing about for months, and I can't wait to actually
He and I have hated each other forever.
Oh. Alright, he knows who I am. Or you probably forgot.
We've never met, though.
Well, he remembered you were Schmack with the Duck PFP, so he probably won't know you now.
Yeah.
He only remembers
he'll probably remember my voice.
No one wants to remember your voice.
Yeah.
I don't think he's showing up. Yeah.
Alright, come on, we just got is there any other servers that we can try to go track him down in right now? He's probably online, knowing him. Trust me, he's probably online. He's gotta be.
I say let's just wait until tomorrow. Like it's
No,
like,
trust me, he's gotta be online. I know this guy too well.
I mean he knows him.
Okay, how long have you known this guy for, Ryan?
Since like August, like maybe late July last year, like he would stay up late. He would stay up to like, can be like 4 or 5 in the morning, debate like talking to people.
Well, so for the camera, can you explain like your history of this guy?
All right, so basically, so back in July or something, I joined a political server, and he was in it. And basically, for some reason was given like a little like trial mod or whatever. And one day we were all getting pinged that there's like a pedophile. And that there's, like, someone abusing their power in VC, so I joined in to check it out. And he was in there just yelling with a bunch of people, with a bunch of kids. And I was, like, asking, like, what's going on? And he was, like, saying, everything's fine, everything's okay. And then I was, like, saying, okay, but who's the pedophile? I got pinged about something like that. And he was, like, there's no... And he started, like, yelling at me. And I basically, of course, yelled at him back. We just got into a giant shouting match. We were disconnecting each other, muting each other. And, like... eventually, because for some reason the owner was really stupid and gave him admin right away, and he basically actually destroyed that server. And he demoted me and everything, and I actually got banned for that server because of him. And basically, I kind of brought him his like knowledge of his existence to my group, my friend group, and everything, and which is here. And we all just started memeing him. We actually talked to him once back when he joined my server, which is now
dead.
it's not defunct, but basically, yeah, he joined that server, and he just blew his nuts. But basically, yeah, he joined the server. He joined the VC one day, and we were all just in there making fun of him. That was the day he really became a big meme. And ever since then, we've kind of like been hoping to get him back someday, and this is what we hope is the kind of like comeback to getting him again.
All right. Okay, Jose.
Like, it was freaking amazing when we used to talk.
Jose, like mute your mic if you got a burp on mute.
And I should make this clear for the record. Yeah, even though I'm not open about my beliefs and whatnot. He's just this guy who goes around debating kids on religion and politics, and it's weird. Generally, we have the exact same views because, like, it seems we're both very Christian, conservative people. But, like, we hate each other because of our personality opposites.
He's more radical. He's more radical.
He's radical. Well, I mean, I definitely am very hardcore about my beliefs. But, like, I'm respectful, is what I'd say.
Yeah.
He's a radical.
I would like to mention this time, apparently one of Schmack's friends, it was like, I think it was Schmack Sandwich 8, burped during a call with him, and he freaked the hell out.
Yeah, he did. I had to bring him back.
Yeah, literally.
You guys got like angry at me for like almost giving him mod, even though I couldn't because I wasn't like admin or owner.
Yeah,
but I did lie.
There's no okay. if you guys ever, if anyone ever wants to get him in your server, kiss his ass, basically. And also, another thing you gotta do is you gotta, like, you have to give him some sort of power to where he can mute and, like, disconnect people. Because, like, if you don't have, if you don't give him any power, then, like, he's, chances are, not gonna last long. And also, you gotta, like, you gotta, like, basically just kind of, like, revolve it around him. You got, he's basically, you know, he basically has the floor. And, like, it's really hard. You'll see everything.
Basically, when he first joins a VC, acts normal, pretty much, until you get on more. Then you can be
understood. Angry.
Yeah. Satanism things, please.
Okay.
I'll just act gay. I'll do.
Okay. Yeah. Hold up. Let me.
I guess if you want.
I'll act gay. Let me get a banana.
Better than Satanism. Check it out. Hello there.
Well, I was invited here to speak to some atheists.
We got a look here.
Leonada is
howdy.
I'll Leonada, see you random numbers are the atheists you were looking for.
I'm not here to debate. I'm just here to witness everything.
Okay.
Well, who would like to defend atheism?
Leonada.
Somebody, Steph. Leonad is muted.
Well, I guess I'll go.
Let me just say this real quick. I'm a Baptist preacher, so I'm on your side here.
All right.
Sir,
yeah, I'm gonna turn you down. Okay, I don't put up with numbskulls. Okay.
What the hell are you on?
Yeah. Wait, hold on, okay. Sir. I'll defend it. I am.
Right. I'm not here to waste my time. If somebody wants to be an atheist and wants to, you know, defend atheism, I'll be glad to hear it.
Okay, I will, because I am. So, I think I should start off with just my experience. Just want to let you know, I grew up in a Christian family, you know, they
all right.
weren't...
All right, just let me just interrupt for a second, okay? I'm not trying to be rude, it's very late for me. I should have gone to bed already. Okay, so I have to leave probably in about 20 minutes. Okay, I'll just ask you a question. Okay, there is no God because.
Well, because it's just, you know, it's just I don't see any proof. There is absolutely no proof.
Okay, now when we talk about God, we're talking about it's clear that you and I and everyone else understand. Not only how God is to be defined, but what you are not believing in. Okay.
Okay.
Right. So, we'll start by having a minimalist definition of God. Okay.
All right.
Okay. So God will be that which is fundamental in reality, the source of all possibility, is a mind, right, and is the creator. All right.
Yes, sir.
Now, so. When you don't believe in God, you're not in a position of neutrality. You can be neutral about many things in life, but there are some things that you simply cannot be neutral toward, right? So, for example, you couldn't be neutral about that anything at all exists. You couldn't be neutral about whether you're dead or alive. So there are some things that you can't be neutral about. Now, there's many things that you can be neutral about. Now, it's very popular that people think that you can be neutral toward God. Well, this is a fallacy. And the reason why is because God is defined as what is fundamental in reality and the source of all possibility. Now, if you don't believe in that, however you want to describe it, all right?
Okay.
Hold on a second. Can you get rid of this video? It's distracting.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, if you don't believe in God for whatever your reason, right, then you're not sitting in a position of neutrality. Then you will be believing in something else that is fundamental, that is not God, okay? You might be clear about it. You might be fuzzy about it. But if you don't believe in God as fundamental as the creator and Lord over creation, then you're going to believe that something else is fundamental that institutes why things are the way they are in terms of regularity and non-regularity, right? So either you will believe what is fundamental is personal, or you will believe in what is fundamental as impersonal. So if you don't believe in God for whatever your reason, in this case, you'll say, well, I don't see how all the facts in my experience in life would stand in causal relations to God. Well, the answer is you abandon that criterion the moment you stop believing in God. Because have you seen how all the facts that you're acquainted with stand in causal relations to what is fundamental that is impersonal? Well, the answer is no, you don't.
Okay.
So it's a phony criterion. It's employed as an excuse not to believe in God, and then it is instantaneously abandoned when sitting in the worldview of not God. So there's only two worldviews. There's God, there's not God, right? And yes, sir. In either world, something's going to be fundamental. Now, if somebody, you know, wants to say, well, I don't even accept anything's fundamental, then if nothing's fundamental, then they don't have any reason to believe in anything, including evidence. Because if nothing's fundamental, then there can't be evidence for anything.
Nothing could be proven. But you believe something's fundamental because you just mentioned proof earlier.
Right. So you believe that something is fundamental, and you decided that it's not. You know what? I'm going to leave. Kick this guy out of here. I'm getting tired of this video popping.
Yeah, kick him.
Kick him out.
Yeah, kick him out.
Yeah, I'll do that, Darth. I'll do it.
Thank you.
Thank you. So what we have, you see, as I said, you can be neutral about many things, but when it comes to God, you can't be neutral. Now, it's widely believed that you can be neutral toward God, and this is something that even fools professional philosophers, right?
All right.
But you can't be, because anyone who says there's neutral toward God, all I have to ask him is one simple question. Do you believe that it is necessary to reference God as the necessary precondition of all facts? Now, I've asked that question of people on Discord. I've asked this of professional philosophers. And the uniform answer is, no, I don't believe it's necessary to reference God as the necessary precondition of all facts. What that answer entails is that they believe in the independence of facts relative to God, that facts simply exist without necessity or reference to God. And if you believe that facts are independent of God, then you believe that God is false, even though somebody maintain, well, but I'm open to somebody showing me there's a God. Doesn't matter. Okay? So agnostics are just fooling themselves that they're neutral, and atheists who want to define atheism as lacktheism, that they're simply unconvinced, are fooling themselves. You either are going to believe what is fundamental is a mind, God, or you will believe the converse, which is what is fundamental, which is not a mind. And what's sauce for the goose is sauce for the gander. If you have a criterion of belief for one, then you have to employ that same criterion of belief for the other. But atheists don't do that.
Okay.
So when you say, I don't see God, well, first of all, that's a category error. Why would you see God? Okay? Why would it necessarily follow in a world where what is fundamental is God that you would necessarily see him? It doesn't follow. Right? Or somebody might say, oh, well, I don't have a good reason to believe in God. Right? Well, what's the good reason to believe in what is fundamental that is not God? What's the reason for that? The answer is they don't have one. Right?
Yes, sir.
So there is a good reason to believe in God, because number one, God has revealed himself in creation and through the course of human history that he has sovereignly recorded in the Christian scriptures. Okay? Now, people are going to reject that. But then I simply say, is the reason to believe in God is that because if you don't believe in God and that God has revealed himself through creation, then you won't have a metaphysical worldview reason to believe in anything else. Because if whatever you tell me you can believe in without needing God, then I'm going to ask you, what is it that imposes that? Is it real or is it an illusion? Now, I spoke with, you ever hear of Lawrence Krauss?
I don't think so.
Okay, Lawrence Krauss is a world famous atheist physicist, and he's debated in many circuits. And he said to me in a mini debate, he goes, well, we don't need to appeal to God. We don't need to appeal to superstitious and magic and supernatural woo-woo. We can explain everything through the laws of nature, right? Does that sound good? Yeah, we don't need God. We can explain everything through the laws of nature. And then I hit him right between the eyes. I said, Dr. Krauss, can you tell me what it is that is ultimate and fundamental and the source of all possibility? And there was a pause, and he goes, I don't know. And why does that even matter? I said, because you told me you could explain everything without God. But obviously you can't. Well, at that point, he had a hissy fit, and he started to be obscene with me and asked the host of the AMA, the Ask Me Anything server, to get rid of me.
Okay, I'm going to keep disconnecting me.
Yeah, don't disconnect him. He's a good guy.
Yeah.
So you see, atheism is untenable. Atheism is incoherent, and it's self-contradictory on its own terms, right? And if you're going to deny God, God would have to exist in a world. Now, when I say in, I don't mean God is in the world. I mean that God exists and is the creator and sustainer of this world in order for affirmation and denial of anything to be viable. Because in a world without God that is not designed by God and operates according to his plan and him endowing us to be like himself, being able to reason and have accessibility to truth and falsity, then truth and falsity could never be arrived at, ever.
Okay.
So you see, atheism is absolutely incoherent, right? And that only leaves us one option, is that all the facts in the world indicate God, and the reason why they do is because they couldn't be facts unless there are two things, a part of God's plan, and they are designed by God to reveal to him. Now, let's take, for example, biology. Richard Dawkins, probably the most world-famous atheist and evolutionist out there, said biology is the study of unbelievably complicated things that appear to be designed, okay? Leonard Susskind, a world-famous atheist physicist, says, yeah, when we look at the universe and we look at the, you know, the things like the cosmological constants and things like that, it appears as it, that it's designed. But then he turns around and he rejects it.
I got a question.
Sure, go ahead.
Is Richard Dawkins, that's his name, right?
Richard Dawkins. Familiar.
Yeah. So have you seen Regular Show?
Have I seen what?
Have you seen Regular Show?
I don't know. No. I don't know what that
is. Okay, excuse me.
It's got a meaningful, like, spiritual message, basically. There's this character named Pop.
He's trolling.
He's just being mean. I actually have a question for you. I didn't really explain why I chose this path, and I kind of want to explain that. I just want to let you know, I never grew up in a broken household. Please mute him. I never grew up in a broken household. My parents were Christian. They raised me well. I love my parents with all my heart. And the reason why I chose this path, because throughout my life, even in my teen years, I questioned the word of God, you know, like...
In your teen years, how old are you now?
I am 17, I'll be 18
younger than you. Oh.
Okay, so let me ask you this question. God does not exist because...
The younger, the better.
Okay, look. God, the reason why is because, well, there's wars going on, and plus, if God sees sin as just a horrible thing... then why doesn't he just snap his fingers?
And... So let's take a look at what you had to say, all right?
Okay.
It does not logically and necessarily follow, because that there are things and events that you find distasteful or objectionable, that what is fundamental in reality is not a mind. It does not follow. What you're attempting to do is you're reasoning that God would have to be like the Christian God, or is the Christian God, and that the Christian God would be incompatible with bad things that are happening on this planet. But if you actually read the Bible actually is a very sophisticated worldview, although it's presented in everyday human terms. Okay, there is no incompatibility between the God of the Bible and his attribute set, including love and benevolence, and the distasteful things that are occurring through the course of human history. And the reason why is because God has a plan to use this present world in its fallen state. The unpleasant things that we see are a temporal judgment upon man, but they serve a purpose to motivate people to turn to the living God and avoid the judgment that they know is coming.
I don't mean to interrupt you, but there's another thing I want to tell you.
One more thing. So this world, let me just say one more thing. This world, with all of its unpleasantness, is the path to the best of all possible worlds. Okay? So the argument for evil, okay? Yeah, can you
mute ever just jerk off?
Can you mute those? Okay?
Let him talk.
Now, all of the unpleasant things that you experience here, hold on, okay? Yep. Yeah, what you're going to need to do is, if you don't start banning these people who keep on doing this kind of crap, I'll just leave and I won't come back.
Okay, please, let me talk, because I want to listen to him.
I was pulling your dick.
Stop, okay? Please, guys, stop, seriously.
Just temporarily ban them.
Okay, yeah, I'm but dude, can I just say something, please? Can I say something, sir?
Go ahead.
Well, I just want to let you know, I kind of have homosexual thoughts, and you look pretty hot.
Fire.
Yeah, that's right, sir. Did he leave?
Go ahead, clown.
Yeah, he left.
What did he leave?
That fucking
boy. Okay, that was amazing.
You're the
king.
Wait, Random, were you recording that?
You better upload that.
The ending was amazing.
Wait, Bundy, did you take your shirt off before you said that?
Yes.
I was gonna get worse.
Actually went through
it. I just banned all of those.
No, don't ban. I wanted to talk to him, damn it.
No, they're all gone.
Come on, you get invited.
Invite him back. Invite him back, and I give him Woody. Sheriff Woody needs to have a talk with him. I need to talk with him.
Is he? Did he leave the server?
He's definitely not joining back after that.
He's still deserving.
Get him in here. I need to talk to him. I'm not hard to talk.
Spam Pinker.
He's sussy for you. Dark Dockies? Yeah.
Random, are you uploading it?
Dude, make me
I was trying so hard to get that burp out whenever the challenge started.